And there's not too much of Sailor Town actually left here. And this is the Catholic Church, still standing here down in Sailor Town. And it's dilapidated. There was a big row in the Catholic Church about this church because people had obviously moved out of the area and attendances were poor, and the Catholic Church voted to close the church, and many of the local people and even people from outside the city who had been locals didn't want this church closed. But it was closed, I believe, anyway. There's the remains of the Rotterdam Bar with a big wall mural beside it that I have videoed elsewhere. And you're coming through this gate out of Clarendon Dock into Sailor Town, or what was then known as Sailor Town, the thriving community, which no longer is. And many a pint was pulled in Pat's Bar, I imagine. And of course, it's sitting idle as well. And there's the... those tram tracks or railway tracks. I just don't know. I'd imagine they're tram tracks. And you can see these all over the place. And there's the old Catholic church up on the left-hand side that I was videoing earlier, and just at the top of the street on the right is a mission to Sailors. I think this must have been Danny's Bar originally, because there's Danny's Cafe, and the American Bar is just round the corner. Short Street. Danny's Meals and Sandwiches and the American Bar. Oh, nice wee bit of graffiti there, highlighting the connection to the sea that this area has. We're down in Short Street, which would have been part of Sailor Town as it was. And there's a plaque up on the wall here outside the Dockers Club. Archaeology of Sailor Town, Belfast. And that Catholic church I was looking at must have been St. Joseph's. Some old photographs of the times gone by. I'll just say, it's a wee memorial plaque to the guys and girls who died working in Belfast, at the Port of Belfast. Even the street names around here give testament to the historical past of the place.